Hi friends, today I am going to discuss about the simplified data encryption standard. Now, in previous session, we are going to discuss the introduction part of the SDS and DES and Feistel cipher and so on. Because of here, in the conventional crypto system, we observed the conventional crypto system is divided into two parts. So, first one is the classical techniques and second one is the modern techniques. What the classical techniques are? Classical techniques are the techniques so which are encrypted the alphabetical data. So classical techniques are the techniques which are encrypted the alphabetical data, and modern techniques are the techniques which are applicable to encrypt the binary data. Now you can observe, so because of why we can take the two different concepts, because of the binary data encryption is not an easy task compared to the textual data, that is the alphabetical data. So in the alphabetical data is encrypted completely, that is the classical techniques. So whatever the pre-standards of the cryptography techniques, all the techniques are applicable to encrypt the textual data, that is nothing but the alphabetical data. So now you can observe there are different types of classical techniques are there. So under the classical techniques, again that there are two types of classical techniques. One is the substitution technique and second one is the transposition technique. In coming to the substitution technique, each element in the plain text is mapping to the other element. That means the mapping to the other element in the sense we can replace that element. Element in the sense here one alphabet is represented as an element. So that is the substitution technique, and the transposition technique is nothing but each element in the plain text are rearranged. Rearranged in the sense the element can be rearranged in a different manner. So that means the position here, the permutation is taken, simply we call as a permutation. So that element can be changed order particularly, that is the transposition technique. In transposition technique also we can observe there are two types of transposition technique, row wise transposition and column wise transposition. The row wise transposition is nothing but we make it arrange the given plain text in a diagonal form and it can read in a sequence manner. So that means we can prepare that message in a diagonal form and we can read as a sequence manner. In the transposition technique, whatever the transpositions are taken, that means in the column wise transposition, which make it arrange one of the column wise. So the first column, second column, third column and the fourth column. So based on that only we can divide the data into that particular order. So that is for the transposition technique. Again the substitution techniques are divided into a different categories. The first substitution technique is the Caesar cipher. So Caesar cipher is the first technique and second one is the monoalphabetic cipher and third one is the Playfair cipher. And fourth one is the polyalphabetic cipher and fifth one is the monoalphabetic cipher technique. So here some of the techniques of related to the classical techniques under the techniques of this particular substitution techniques. And in the transposition techniques only one technique is arranged, that is nothing but a rotor machine. And coming to the modern techniques, what the modern techniques is nothing but a modern techniques are the techniques so which are applicable the encryption pattern on binary data. So the binary data starts with the 8 bit is the minimum data and the 16 bit is the second one and third 32 bit is the third one and 64 bit is the next one and so on. That means the minimum block of data. So because why we have to consider this criteria is nothing but in the dimensions of the cryptography, what the first dimension is nothing but the type of operation which we convert the plain text into cipher text. What the type of operations here we can observe the substitution techniques and the transposition techniques. And the second one is the number of keys are used. Number of keys are used in the sense here there are two types of keys are used in the cryptography. One is the single key, that is for the conventional, the two keys cryptography, that is the public key cryptography. The public key cryptography is the one of the keys, the public key, and the second one is the private key. So that we can discuss in the coming in the previous sessions of the public key cryptography. Now you can observe the SDS is the process, that is simplified data encryption standard. SDS stands for a simplified data encryption standard. What the SDS is nothing but Simplified data encryption standard is the standard which encrypted the 8-bit data. Now you can observe this is the criteria of this particular information to encrypt the 8-bit data in a different manner. Now you can observe this SDS is considered the two parts. One is the SDS key generation and the second part is the SDS encryption and decryption. So in this video I am going to explain so what the exactly the concept of the SDS key generation. So because the key generation is the main portion or the important part in the encryption or the decryption pattern. Already in the first video, first and second video, we are going to discuss the importance of the key, because the key is the heart of the cryptography. So without key we can't encrypt the data. Now you can observe the SDS, simplified data encryption standard. SDS is the concept or the algorithm to encrypt the minimum of 8-bit data. The 8-bit data is encrypted. So now in the SDS we have to identify the key generation. Here in the diagram which is shown, one of the procedure, what the procedure is, we can take the 10-bit key here. So actually whatever the size of plain text, the same size of keys are used here only, because the key will not differ compared to the plain text. That's why a key is a value which is independent on the plain text message, because of whatever the key size is defined, that key is, depends on the plain text message. If the plain text is 8-bit, the key should be the 8-bit. If the plain text is 16-bit, the key should be the 16-bit. If the plain text is the 32-bit, if the key size is the 32-bit, and so on like that. So here the 8-bit key is used, 8-bit plain text is used. So we will compare that particular 8-bit plain text with the key order. What the key order size is, key order is also the 8-bit. So now you can imagine the key size is the 8-bit, but here we can consider the 10-bit. What the SDS key generation algorithm, the 10-bit key is taken and apply the permutation. Here you can observe the permutation. The permutation of Pn in the above, it will be the shows the permutation P10. The P10 is the one of the permutation. We make it arrange that particular data in this order. That is the first, second, third, fourth, and so on. The 10th position are there in the given plain text. So that key order is converted into the P10. P10 is nothing but the 3, 5, 2, 7, 4, 10, 9, 9, 8, 6. So the positions are here the change, but the element will not be changed. So that we can observe transposition technique. In the transposition, each element in the plain text are rearranged. Here we make it change some order of the given plain text. So here it is the P10. So the P10 is taken, that P10. Now you can observe here what the procedure is. The P10 is divided into the two blocks, that is the LS1 and LS2. What the LS1 is, nothing but the left shift operation by 1 bit and the left shift operation by 1 bit. That means here the 5-bit data is applied to the left shift operation. What the left shift operation here we can observe. How we can shifted that particular order is, suppose 10101. If I take this data, left shift operation is this left shift bit data is converted into this position. Then the data becomes, here you can observe 0101 and 1. So this is the left shift operation by 1, left shift operation by 1. So similarly, this particular data is taken in this order, the left shift by 1 bit data. Now that data is applied to the P8. Again here you can consider the P8 data. The P8 data is one more permutation P8, which takes the any different order. In a different order means whatever the left shift operation by 1 bit data will be combined both, and also we can get the 10 bit data. That 10 bit data is converted into the 8 number bit data, that is a P8. Here one more permutation is taken, that is 6 3 7 4 8 5 10 9. Here you can observe, so that can be applied to the P8 to the 10 bit data. That means the 2 bits are here eliminated, that is by the user choice. Here you can observe the permutations are always depends on the user choice itself. The user itself is taking the permitted choice and he applied the permitted choice to the given data. So now whatever the 8-bit is derived, that derived the 8-bit is nothing but the K1. Now the K1 is derived. So the K1, what is the size of the K1 here? The 8 bits. So the given plain text is nothing but the 8 bit. So that means here the exact bits are equal. The whatever the key, plain text size is there, the key size must be taken the same size. So the K1 is derived. After that, you can observe here the given procedure. The LS1 data is taken and again applied to the LS2 data. In the previously, only one bit can be moved from left to right. Here the two bits at a time can be moved from left to right. So here that you can observe simply, suppose the given bits are 10101, here the two bits are changes in the left bits to right bits, then the elements are 10110. So this is the 2-bit left shift. The 2-bit left shift in the sense, so we can shift the 2 bits at a time to the left to right. This is the concept of LS2. Now the both LS2 data will be combined, then it can be formed as again the 10 bits. So now the 10 bits are applied to the same permutation which are taken in the previous. That means whatever the P8 is taken, the same permutation is taken there, and again we can apply the P8 here. So to the left shift 2 data, and finally we can derive the K2. So here you may be observed the two keys are derived. One is the K1 here and the K2 here. So the K1 is the key which is the 8 bit, and the K2 is the key which having also 8 bits. Now you can consider this is the SDS key generation. So the key generation is the separate part compared to the encryption and decryption, because of in both users can use the single key operation in both encryption and decryption. That is the part of the conventional crypto system, because in the conventional crypto system only the SDS is applied. So the conventional crypto system under the classical techniques and the modern techniques, the SDS is the part of the modern techniques which can be applied the initial data of that particular 8-bit data. So the 8-bit data is given this order. You may be observed the 10-bit key is used. After 10 bit, we take the permutation P10, and again the P10 can be divided into the two equal parts, the LS1 and LS2 data, and again the LS1 data and LS1 data both are combined, and finally we can form as the permutation P8. So the P8 is the key one. Now you can take the LS1 data and apply to the divide the data into two halves. That is LS2 is the 5-bit data. LS2 is the one more LS2 is the left side data, that is also the 5-bit data. Now we can apply the same procedure of the P8 to the LS2 data after completion of the left shift by 2 bits. Then finally we can consider the P8 here. The P8 is the permutation, so which can be taken the data which can be applied to that permutation P8 to the 10-bit data, and finally we derive the K2. So this is the K1 and K2 generations of this particular SDS simplified data encryption standard. Once again, I can repeat where the SDS can be defined is in conventional crypto system. Conventional crypto system are the two parts, a classical techniques and the modern techniques. Again, the classical techniques are divided into substitution technique and the transposition technique. Again, the substitution techniques are divided into the first one is the Caesar cipher, mono alphabetic cipher, Hill cipher, Playfair cipher, and poly alphabetic cipher techniques. These are the 5 techniques under the classical techniques. And coming to the substitution technique, and coming to the transposition techniques, again the only the rotor machine is there. And again coming to the modern techniques are taken the operation to encrypt the binary data. So the binary data will be started from the 8 bit onwards. So that's why the 8 bit data is taken for encryption of the SDS. So the SDS is encrypted that 8-bit data. So with having the different notations, first we can understand this particular concept of the key generation. Once we make it understand the key concept generation, then we can apply the K1, K2 into the encryption of SDS and decryption of SDS that we have to discuss in the next video. Thank you.